Thank you, Linda. Thanks also the organizer for having inviting us to in fact present sort of what we are doing at international level, especially through the Innovation Challenge 5, converting sunlight to fuel. And also my colleagues Thomas will present what we are doing also at European. So again, thank you. And he will present the results of the Challenge 5. So I will be still here for answer any question if you need. Thomas, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Linda. Thank you, Philippe. It's a pleasure to be invited to this meeting, and I'm looking forward to hear more about the initiative and also about the discussion. So as I wanted, can you see the screen now in the slideshow?
We see it in full mode now,
okay.
Yes.
All right. So I will actually start with a little bit the European perspective before then going to mission innovation and the roadmap. So if we think about research and innovation, it must have the ambition and it has to contribute to the general policy framework, of course, which is in Europe determined by the strategy package, which was already implemented before towards an energy union, with the scenarios and the strategies built up in clean energy for all Europeans, and now, of course, as a new element, the European Green Deal, to which I will come on the next slide. I mean, we have the agreed headline targets, which put a strong focus on reducing greenhouse gas emissions and an increased focus in increasing the share of renewables together with energy efficiency. And on the other side, it is also clear that we cannot, on the international scale, achieve the ambition of the Paris Agreement without research and innovation. So it's imperative to bring innovative technologies to the market. Energy policy is, of course, as such, interlinked with many other policy domains and also markets, and therefore there are strong links, for example, with digital policy, but also with growth and sustainable development. Now, the European Green Deal, it's the EU ambition to become the climate neutral by 2050, and this in synergy with protecting human life, animals, and plants, as well as to provide competitive clean energy technology industry landscape. Together with this, it has also the ambition to, of course, to have a just and inclusive transition, so to have the citizen really on board. Going, I hope you will be able to share the slides afterwards. Of course, we cannot go through the whole screen here, but I invite you to look at the respective communications in more detail. Some highlights here, which I think are relevant in the context of solar fuels. The Green Deal communication talks about ramping up the production and deployment of sustainable alternative fuels. The smart energy system integration strategy specifies this further by, of course, putting a strong focus on electrification where possible. But for those sectors where not, the use of renewable and low carbon fuels is also encouraged here and supported, in particular for some specific sectors like maritime, aviation, and certain industrial processes, but also the interlinkage between sustainable biogas, biomethane, as well as renewable low carbon hydrogen and synthetic fuels. So I think there's a lot of room here, and the hydrogen strategy, of course, defines this further by supporting also hydrogen derived synthetic fuels. So I think this is a lot of relevant policy background, which I cannot go in detail now, but in my tutorites, together, of course, there is also the interaction, which I think we have to think about, how renewable fuels act in concert with hydrogen on one side, with biofuels on the other side. Now, how will this all translate in research innovation? Now we are in the phase of Horizon Europe, of course, the framework program from 21 until 27. I cannot tell you any details yet on the specific work program. What we in the Clean Energy Directorate are responsible for is the EUC in Pillar 2, the Cluster Climate, Energy and Mobility. And here in specific, we invite you then, of course, when it's published, to look in particular at the possibilities there for renewable fuels, biofuels, etc. But as always, of course, there are the other two pillars also, as well as other cluster programs, and then the hydrogen partnership, etc., and all the other European Union programs, which can be relevant and then, of course, can be screened by you for what is relevant. To go a little bit more into cluster five, what is in the current draft here, as said, not legally binding, of course, yet, as not endorsed. But here we have topics with, or let's say, ideas with affordable, secure, and sustainable renewable energy technologies. Also linking them specific needs as aviation, shipping, heating, cooling industry, the whole interaction with grids, with CCUS, and in generally, it is important to look at the sustainability of renewable energy value chains. International cooperation is an important element, and partnerships on hydrogen as well as on clean energy transition. I invite you to, this is in the EU bookstore available now, in a study led by Ernst & Young, we looked at solar fuels research and invest at the solar fuel value chain in the global context. This is now available for download. I cannot go in detail, only to inform you about this. And it is interesting, I think, in particular also scenarios with very long term, because we looked up to 2100 here. And we will also probably organize a specific webinar on that. Now coming to mission innovation. As a global intergovernmental initiative working to accelerate clean energy innovation, as you know, there is Mission Innovation Challenge 5 on solar fuels, which I will come now to the roadmap. But in particular, the goals to boost public sector investment and increase private sector engagement and international cooperation, as well as raising awareness, I think they're all underlying also the challenge. Of course, we have to see at which TRL scale we are. The objective of challenge 5 was, and now is at the end phase, to discover affordable ways to convert sunlight into storable solar fuels. And with many countries participating in this challenge. And the reason, let's say, highlight was the completion of the converting sunlight into solar fuels and chemicals roadmap with the timescale 2020 to 2050. And this was a cooperative exercise with many participants. Here I see Leif and Karina, who contributed to that one. So we took in the visions, let's say, around the world for that. I don't have a lot of time to go into the specifics, but basically it defines the role of Mission Innovation Challenge in the global context. Then establish the vision in a value chain approach, and then And the third chapter goes into more detail into the different conversion technologies and then links it back to system integration, as well as the role in a circular economy approach, which I think links also very well to your synergy presentation before. So I said, I mean, the center, of course, is the conversion technologies in the middle of the value chain, but also the roadmap tries to assess a little bit what are the upstream interfaces and the downstream interfaces and what is required there to move ahead. It covers different technologies as defined by the challenge, so photochemical, photoelectrochemical, thermochemical, and biochemical approaches, and also different downstream products, so it's open there. I think I do not go into the details of the technologies here. Importantly, the PV electrolysis and synthesis technology is an important reference technologies, which provides kind of the context of, let's say, the reference bar to the other technologies, which are, of course, a different TRL level. And importantly, so you will see when you look at the roadmap for the different technologies shown here on the left side, the roadmap tries to first define what is the technology readiness level of the core elements, what are the respective research goals, major challenges, and necessary key enabling technologies, as well also the aim to define what are important milestones for bringing these technologies to the next level. So we invite you all to look at this, which provides a little bit the, let's say, the global context, also in respect to what you propose at the European scale for the synergy. And thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much, Tom.